My name is Jack, Jack Torrance. I'm the Overlook Hotel caretaker, and it's my job, as good as it gets. I'm writing my new novel, at least I think I am. Images come to mind, more and more often. A horror story with a child. Children are good. They stir things up inside. It's crazy, but ever since my wife got out of my hair, I've finally been able to write. Here they come, more images.
You.
I'm used to peculiar things happening in this hotel.
Come to me.
But things were getting weirder and weirder. Like this red-haired woman on the television screen who was talking to me. Calling out for me.
Come to me now.
She was calling out for me again.
Don't keep me waiting.
Again and again.
Please.
It felt like she wanted to suck up my inspiration. Days are very strange in this hotel. There's neither day nor night, and I feel neither hunger nor the need to sleep. It's like a dream, or rather, a nightmare. Yesterday, I was outside looking for my son in the maze. Or maybe it was last week or a month ago. Everything is so confused. After that, I found myself at my typewriter alone. It's actually better to be alone to write, even the days I don't feel like it. I try to write at least 10 pages.
Physically, it's not a very demanding job. The only thing that can get a bit trying up here during the winter is a tremendous sense of isolation. Because for some people, solitude and isolation can, of itself, become a problem.
Each time I made my rounds, I wondered why clients kept the doors cracked open. And because curiosity and writing go together, I was dying to walk inside and watch. And when I saw this woman there, I couldn't resist. I walked into the room. Curiously, the colors seemed to disappear.
Oh, it's
came back every day. The same woman was still there.
She's alive.
I killed her again. I killed her again and again. And again. When I walked in, she was there. But each day I felt she was tearing something out of me. Every time I walked by room 1408, I could hear a man screaming to get out. In room 14, there was a couple. They were playing strange games. Once again, I imagined what could be happening behind this door. That's what writing is, imagining the pains and joys of others. Even though all these people could have been sources of inspiration, the idea that my story should revolve around children kept coming back. I was actually obsessing over it. It was rather fortunate, as there were many children in this hotel. I could go around the rooms. Little Damien was in room 666. He was a little weird. There was also the kid from room 13.
Got you something, Mommy.
Really strange, this one.
They're here.
The little girl in room 9 was also seeing ghosts everywhere. But the only one I spoke with was the boy in room 6, who had stopped getting out of bed. The kid reminded me of my son. Where is my son, by the way? You called out for me. What did you need to tell me?
I see dead people.
In your dreams?
Jack is dead, my friend.
No.
You
can call me Joker.
Strange, I hadn't seen my wife and son for a few days. And I had never been so inspired. I was possessed by my story. I stopped sleeping. I was writing in order to breathe, so that blood could run through my veins. I was writing to keep my sanity.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, here's Johnny!
Here's Johnny!
I split my time between writing and boredom.
You can come in now.
So I sat in front of the TV, watching anything and everything. Interesting. This man in the film looks like a younger version of me.
My name is Wilberforce.
Wilberforce what?
Just Wilberforce. My first name is Wilbur, my last name is Force. I don't have a middle name.
I felt like I was falling back into my old insanity from before. From before the hotel, all sorts of oddities invaded my mind. I had opened a secret window, and things were pouring out. Horrible things. It was both terrifying and fascinating, like when you know you have a good grasp on the story. When characters come and talk to you, it was almost like a kind of rapture. Every single room in this hotel led imagination to ravings. For instance, the Great Hall. The place where the young girl had killed almost everyone present before starting the fire. Almost burned to the ground. The headline had inspired a young writer for his first novel. His name escapes me now. I like this bar. I'm alone. alone facing the vital need to create, as if I stood on a tightrope between two worlds, using my craft for balance, my writing preventing me from falling. Each step could very well be the last, and yet, it's impossible to renounce crossing over. But who is this old man in the mirror? He's whining like a little girl because he had failed as a writer, a father, and a husband.
You've had your whole fucking life!
What the hell do I care? Get out. I don't even know you. I'm positive I don't know you. You're pathetic. I'm not that old man, and I'll never be. It's strange, although what isn't in the Overlook Hotel? I have the feeling that I went out the other night. It could have been a nightmare. I remember having forced open a door. Outside. It's fuzzy in my head. One more time, I found myself sitting in front of my typewriter, without the memory of having returned, except one of pain in my skull. But first and foremost, I've got to ask myself some questions. A good writer always asks the right questions. Should my novel be scary? Very scary, or not scary at all. You don't really negotiate fear. You can't have all three at the same time, or maybe you can, actually. It's precisely this balance that makes a good horror story.
So, what's on your mind?
It had been a while since Hannibal paid me a visit. I feel like I'm carrying the misery of the world on my shoulders.
Fascinating. You know, I always suspected as much. You are more keen to artistic imagination. You're able to assume the emotional point of view of other people, even though they might scare or sicken you, Jack.
Yes, I'm scared, but it's fascinating.
It's a troubling gift, I should think. I'd love to get you on my couch.
It scares me. But I feel the inspiration coming to me.
It'll come to you.
My confidence was bolstered by that conversation. You're always looking for a story that will entertain, and I write horror stories. It's my signature. And this place, this hotel, was the hub of terror. There was a birth. I actually couldn't see the baby. There it goes, another cracked open door. It's room 999. I went in, of course. A young girl was lying on the bed.
What an excellent day for an exorcism.
But I'm not an exorcist.
It's just a jump to the neck.
It burns!
And it burns!
With your hands on your hips!
something. Ah, yes. I tried one more time to leave. As each time I find myself here, without understanding, maybe I won't be able to leave the Overlook Hotel before I finish writing my book. I am going to write this book, and it will be the most terrifying story I could imagine. I was overwhelmed by ideas. They were colliding in my head like fireworks. Monsters were swirling around, coming to life one after the other. Like a mashup of ideas from all walks of life. Both the puppets and my masters. And amongst them, Pennywise was alive before my eyes. He was terrifying, even to me, but I understood that if I wanted to get a hold of my novel, I would have to accept it. Just like death, creation takes you alone. However, what I create, I can destroy.
I can destroy you whenever I want.
In the snowstorm at night and seeing from afar the shining lights of my hotel. They will come looking for shelter. They're young. I'm sure they'll want to read my book.
It's open. Come on.
Oh, come on. Come on in.
What is this place?
Welcome to the horror.
Looks like we're visiting for the night. is it so warm in here?
There's a janitor here.
Yeah, they probably keep the boiler going so the pipes won't freeze.
You're really lucky this place was here, man.
Hey, check this out.